morning. You are very welcome for this service, this Sunday's Garage. We are so glad you could join us. We are so glad to have you this day. We know that you are watching us online. Some of you are making your way to the room. We are just so glad to have you. My name is Rachel.
Oh, yes. My name is Cassius, but you can call me.
Call you who?
Rachel's husband. And good morning, people. How are you doing?
Oh, yes.
On this Sunday morning that
a is beautiful a, one. Yeah, it's a really beautiful. Interesting it's a
bit,
Sunday.
It's a bit chilly, but beautiful.
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
Right here at Worship Harvest Nalia, where we are live. Mm-hmm. We have very many people. Some of them have just come from the 8 a.m. service.
Oh, yes. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. I wanted to brag about it.
Uh-huh.
Do you know why we have an 8 a.m. service?
Tell us why. I know, but some people may not know. Just tell us why.
It's because the parking wasn't enough for one service.
I love our problems. I love Worship Harvest's
beautiful problems.
Oh, yes. That's such a good problem.
Mm-hmm. Guys, please make your way to the room if you're not yet in the room.
Yes, especially those that did not make it for the 8 a.m. garage.
For Nalia. But
for Nalia, yes. Yeah. That's for
but
Nalia.
Others, I hope you're already making your way to the to church. Mm. If your service starts at 10.
Yes.
I know already in church.
But yes.
Oh, yes. It's a good time. So tell me.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me something nice.
So, first of all, us as Worship Harvest, we made 18 years.
We are adults.
We are adults.
Like you.
Yes. So, we had our 18 hours of worship that ended. Okay. The celebrations did not end on Sundays. Just at the 18 hours of worship are the ones that ended on Sunday.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. But the celebrations are still going on because it's been 18 years of God's goodness, 18 years of God's presence, 18 years of God's glory.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yes. But
18 years of winning.
Oh, yes. However, mm-hmm. I know something happened right here on Friday, and I think you're the best person to tell us what that was.
What happened on Friday?
Oh, yes.
You see, Friday, okay, we had what they call the man talk.
Okay, that's interesting.
That's the talk for the men.
Oh, okay, it's in the name. Mm-hmm.
Because I'm a man.
Uh-huh.
So we had a men talk.
Uh-huh.
And a men talk means there were very many men.
Okay.
Was your man there?
We hope
so. Was your husband there?
Yeah, we hope so. Let me first chip in. Just in case the answer is no, we still have the recording on YouTube. It was recorded, so you can find it on YouTube.
Yeah, and do a rewatch.
Uh-huh. So tell us what happened.
You want to know what happened?
I want to know some highlights.
Secrets. You want highlights. You go and watch. You don't want to spend data.
No.
Anyway, so the man talk was so good.
Uh-huh.
And one of my highlights is a man needs friends.
Okay.
And you can't be a man with no friends.
That's true. No? That's true.
You can't make decisions with no friends.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So a man needs friends.
Okay.
You don't have to be alone.
Mm-hmm. And I think that means good friends.
Mm-hmm. Another thing that I liked so much was a man has to be a husband.
Okay.
A husband is not just a title. A husband has a thing behind it.
Okay.
A man has to bind the house.
Mm.
Has band. You're the binder. You understand?
Okay.
Uh-huh. Mm. So a man has to bind.
Yeah, the family.
It has to bind the family.
Okay.
And of course, women love men that are husbanding. You understand?
I get it.
Am I husbanding? Am I doing you well?
You're doing a good job. That's what I can say. You're doing a good job.
Only.
No, you're an amazing job. A great job.
Oh my God. Okay, jokes. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So tell me.
So it seems like you guys had fun. Eh? Okay.
We had fun.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. So tell me. Mm. Something is going to happen on Thursday.
Yes. So from Thursday.
Next week.
Yes. Is it next week, this week?
Mm-hmm.
18th. Mm. From 18th Thursday to Saturday, we have Proclaim happening right here at Worship Harvest Nalia. Oh, yes.
Mm.
I have grabbed my ticket. Tickets are still on sale at 150,000 Uganda shillings only. Definitely.
So
150,000 Uganda shillings only. Like, only.
Mm.
I mean, you can skip lunch for a few days.
In Worship Harvest, we are rich. We do not need to skip lunch.
I'm just saying, just in case. I'm just giving them some tips.
Ask the leaders.
You know, some people may say, what? No. Just pay 150,000 Uganda shillings or the equivalent in Kenya shillings or US dollars.
Oh, yes,
we are international like that.
And
I want to tell you,
will not regret it.
Oh,
it's
yes.
going to be awesome. We're going to have men of God that are flying from
different countries.
Different countries, yes. From different places.
Oh, coming yes.
here to just put wisdom in, give us knowledge.
Oh, yes.
So that we can understand some things.
Oh, yes.
And there are revelations will come.
I like it so much. I like it so much already. And now, guys. Today.
Mm-hmm, today.
Today.
Before today. Okay. Make your way to the room.
Oh, yes.
As we tell you what's going to happen today. So if you're coming to Nalia, please make your way to Nalia.
Ali. Oh, yes.
If you're going to your location, make your way to the location that you can come directly to Nalia. Because what's happening?
At 4 p.m. right here at Worship Harvest Nalia again.
At 4 o'clock.
4 o'clock.
O'clock.
Yes, 4 p.m. We have the Movers and Shakers garage that is happening. If you are energetic like me,
we have the Movers and Shakers garage.
Energetic like me.
Energetic
like me.
The 50 young, the 40 young.
Oh, yes.
The 30 young.
Yes.
The 20.
This garage is just for you.
Uh-huh.
You cannot afford to miss it. It starts at 4 p.m., but that doesn't mean that come at 4 p.m. Mm. You don't want to be the one sitting behind and, you know, trying to...
You get a stand and all that, that stuff.
Just so you see what's happening. No. Come in front so that you grab yourself a front seat.
And if you're complaining that you'll be hungry, we have brain cafe.
Yes.
That you eat.
So tell them what they can do. Hmm? After their service.
Yeah, after your service at 2, just directly come to Worship Harvest Nalia. Because we are going to have a guest preacher.
Oh, yes.
I don't want to tell you the name because you will go and search about them. Come here and know about them.
They may say, I already know the preacher. I no longer need to come. No, that's okay.
You may want to be online, but let me see the preacher online.
No, please. You know, the morning service, people watch online. It's okay. Those who can make it, but they choose to stay in their beds as pyjama church. Now, what do we call the ones who come in the evening? Who can't come in the evening because they just don't want to?
Lazy church.
No, I doubt it. I doubt it.
So if you're not lazy, please make your way.
Oh, yes, at 4 p.m.
Please make your way to the room.
Yeah,
at
you
4
cannot
PM.
Afford to miss it.
So tell me, we had MC.
Oh, yes.
On Wednesday.
Every Wednesday.
Yeah.
We actually have... Let me just say that just in case some of you do not know. I know we have first-time guests every time. And we may have those that aren't members of Worship Harvest, but they would love to be. We have MC every Wednesday.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, just like this previous week, we had MC. That happens in areas that are around us. Oh, yes.
At your home, in the comfort of your home.
And also, we have the Christ Jane Garage. CGG, the Christ Jane Garage.
Yeah.
That happens every Saturday, right? From 3 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
In the youth auditorium. That
at
is
Worship
a Ben.
Harvest, Nalia.
Yes, that is a Ben Mugarira youth auditorium.
Oh, yes, but then, so, you see, as we're making this... this thing nice for you. Please don't forget that you have to make your way to the room. You might be like, oh, these hosts are so good. No.
Yeah.
Get on your shoes.
Uh-huh.
Get your car keys.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Call your judge guy with the umbrella.
Definitely.
And make your way to the room.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yes, get your judge, your Kawasaki and all that nice stuff.
Uh-huh.
And make your way to the room.
Also,
share the link.
Exactly. We are aware some people cannot make it to the room for whatever reason it is. Just share the link. Get it on your WhatsApp status. Get it on all your socials. You don't know where the link will reach.
Send it to all your disciples that you know are up country and can't get to church.
Yes.
So that they can watch and they should give you reflections. You should also send your reflections to the YouTube chat.
What a discipler. What a discipler. You're such a discipler.
Oh, yes. Because right about now, we're about to start. And
I'm so excited.
So excited.
Yeah,
what
I'm also very excited
for today.
A good word, definitely. I'm going to receive a good word.
Mm-hmm.
The praise and worship is going to be on point.
It's going to put you on fire.
Guest experience is already serving smiles and vibes.
Oh, yes. Hugs and all.
Tell me, why wouldn't you come?
Like, why wouldn't I be a Worship Harvest?
Yes, such if you don't nice come, you'll family be the only one because we are actually about to go live in about five, four, three, two, one. Let's go.
did you pray to Jesus this morning?
Come on, somebody sing.
I bless the Lord all the time. His praise will never be in my mouth. I bless the Lord all the time. His praise will never be in my mouth.
I bless the Lord.
I'm Yeah. Thank you, Lord. We are winners in your name. Woo! When all is seen and shame, there's greater gift and grace. The love of God is broader working for our good. When all is seen and shame, there's greater gift and grace. The love of God is broader working for our good. We find pleasure in knowing in His presence and very self. The whole universe testifies of His working alive. So sing!
Join with us. hearts in heaven and the nations sing with one voice to the ancient of days.
Let's sing together.
With joy we love.
Of kings, keep clapping your hands to the Ancient of Days, the one who rose again, the one who was and is to come, the victorious one, the triumphant one. Come on, clap your hands like you mean it, like you have got the victory in the presence of the Lord. Come on, Jesus, what's the name we are clapping to?
Jesus.
I say, Jesus, what is the name?
Jesus.
Magnific. You are all welcome to Garage.
Welcome.
Turn to your neighbor, welcome them, give them a fist bump.
Give them a fist bump, give them an elbow, tell them you look amazing. Welcome to the house of the Lord. Come on, say hello to your neighbor. Online, at the different locations that are watching us this morning, you're specially welcome. We love it that you're here on Spirit TV, Spirit Radio. Thank you so much for choosing to worship with us this morning. Please do take your seats. Welcome to Worship Harvest Nadia. Hey. Well, my name is Pastor Flo.
My name is Steve, but you can call me
Steve the Rev.
Wow, and together we have the incredible privilege of leading Worship Harvest Mbarara.
Okay.
And the Multipliers Network. Now in Mbarara, we have something we say. Mm-hmm. If you see someone looking really good like I'm doing right now.
That's right.
You say, no rebakaje.
No.
So tell your neighbor, neighbor.
Neighbor.
No rebakaje.
No rebakaje.
Kwa kwa chiromuka. Welcome home.
Would you please give it up for our very anointed worship team that has led us so beautifully. Thank you so much. We love it.
All right. How many people were here on Friday? Let's see. What were you doing here? Online. How many men were here for Man Talk? Hey. Why don't you help me celebrate those amazing brothers, husbands, priests of our homes, and help me celebrate Apostle Mose for gathering our men.
Yeah.
It was really beautiful and amazing.
Well, I would like to recognize a special group of people. I'm talking about the people who are here today for their very first time.
Oh, yes.
The first time guests, if you're here today for your very first time, you can put up your hand and we are going to do
first
all the rest.
First time guests? The balcony? Any first Anybody? Time guests?
Some. I see a hand back there.
Right
I see another
there.
Hand right
Second
there.
Second hand right there. There's another hand right there. Come on, Worship Harvest.
And if you're joining us from one of our locations and it's your very first time, we are glad to have you. Thank you for joining us.
And now why don't we tell our first time guests as well as remind ourselves who we are. Worship Harvest, who are we?
We are a movement of the gospel, discipleship, and mission.
And we are committed to the sole purpose of
catalyzing
spiritual, social, and economic renewal in our immediate communities. And as a result, the world. What do?
We plant life-giving, disciple-making, community-renewing churches.
And we believe that
church begins on Monday and Sunday is garage time.
Beep, beep. Why don't you turn your eyes to the screen for the video announcements?
Gentlemen, welcome to Man Talk 24.
Come on.
One of the things men are suffering with is who is a man? A man is a leader. So you need another man to brighten the way you actually think. The proverb says that foolishness is bound in the heart of the child. So foolishness is in the child. Two fools cannot lead each other. It is therefore incumbent that men step up and be the men to lead the children, the boys.
Find someone that's doing something great, follow them hard, read their books, go to places where they are, learn from them, get into their spaces.
I've noticed that the people who are doing marriage well either had a physical father who was doing well, who has patterned something for them, or they have a spiritual father who is patterning something for them. So they sort of know what to do when and how, which sort of creates protection.
We're not looking for a perfect man, but we are looking for a healthy man. Perfection, that's spiritual. By one offering, he has perfected forever those who are being sanctified. If you're trying to look for perfection in the flesh, it's not going to be there. In the spirit, we are totally perfect. Point is not what you are achieving. The point is who you are becoming.
Hello, my name is Nachintu Priscilla Ndimukulaga. From Worship Harvest Nalia. I thank God so much for this church. I thank God so much for what he's doing. We joined Worship Harvest in 2022, November. And in 2023, we started hearing about first fruit and the testimonies. It was wow. So I tell my husband about it. We took a step of faith in 2024 January. During season 21, we start seeing God working. And during the testimonies, Pastor Jonah gave a testimony about his daughter being given full scholarship until she's done with school.
Then in season 21, this year, somebody walks to me and says, I think I need to take up one of your children. I'm like, what do you mean? They say that your eldest daughter, where does she go to school? And she's on an international curriculum.
Ring.
Like, I am going to pay for school fees, for the her school fees for the rest of her life.
So I received the promise, the prophecy. For my son who had just finished PLE and was joining Senior One in February. So we take a step of faith and give in this first fruit, end of January. So as we took our son to school, one of my friends saw my status and she was like, wow, where did you take him? Was it his first choice? Which schools did Jermaine want? I was like, he wanted to go to Namgongo and Namiliango. Those were his first choices. Then she was like, you go to these schools and find out whether he can be taken in back in second term. I was like, what? She was like, I'm going to pay his tuition until he's done with school. You can't believe how I felt that moment. It was a moment of bliss. I was like, wow. And you see me here, I'm not worried about tuition anymore. As if that was not enough, she told me to sell off my car because it was giving us issues. So she said, whatever I get out of that car, she's going to add on so that we get a new car. Because when we were coming back from school, we had issues and she got to know about it. So she told us she's going to help us get a new car. That is the Lord we serve. And as if that was not enough, season 21, we had issues. I had issues with my sisters, two sisters. And one of them was diagnosed with cancer, colon cancer, beginning of 2023. She was diagnosed with colon cancer. The other one had a stroke in 2021, which left her brain so damaged that she could not even do anything for herself. Apparently, after season 2021, this lady can do so much. She can talk, she can eat by herself, she can hold a cup. And the other one called me and told me she's free from cancer, like they cannot see cancer anymore after so much prayer in 2021. So I'm grateful for this church family and what God is doing for us. Thank you.
Are you ready?
Next up.
Hey! Hey!
Kelly.
I want to see you! Everybody go!
Dig in. So I've come to discover that the primary interest of the Lord of the harvest is the harvest. Now you will realize that the greatest harvest in Africa is amongst the young people. Most of the people respond to the gospel when younger, not when older.
What is discipleship? Who is a disciple? Why must we make disciples? How do we make disciples?
Evangelism without a community to receive the souls, it's a production of spiritual orphans.
When you see 5% of salvation in a given area, in a given demographic, in a given people group, you're beginning to get to movement.
Discipleship is not for demagogues.
A disciple is one who learns like a child.
Anything else in your body that is not connected or attached to anything, they are called free radicals. Because they are not attached to anything, to anywhere, no system, no cell, no accountability, nothing. They are just in the body. We love the Lord.
Just because you're a pastor, a preacher, is not guaranteed that you're a disciple maker.
If you don't like our missional community style.
Come on, victory dance. Victory dance. Victory dance. What's your victory dance? Victory dance.
What's up, everybody? My name is Steve Bachuk and call me Steve the Rev. Well, the victory dance is simply because the celebration still continues for our 18 years of worship harvest. If you thought we stopped last week, you're kidding yourself. And if you didn't join us for the 18 hours, God still loves you. Now, the book of Jeremiah 30:19 says, then out of them shall proceed thanksgiving and the voice of those who make merry. I will multiply them and they shall not diminish. I will also glorify them and they shall not be small. God is still taking us on a greater journey. Well, we used to be a people that never used to have a place we could call our home. Matter of fact, we used to be on a veranda. But now we have several cathedrals. We have several 360 structures. But guess what? We just made 18 and it has only just started. Paint this picture with me. 1,000 cathedrals, 20,000 360 structures, 10,000 pieces of land across the globe. Imagine 1 million disciples out of this church. It just got started. Can you imagine? We've already tailed Worship Harvest Ginger fully. Can you imagine? Together you have so far pledged 8.334 billion Uganda shillings, and so far you have given 3.8 5.2 billion Uganda shillings. Come on, somebody. This is to let you know we just got started and you still have the opportunity of joining us on this journey. Go ahead, pledge and give towards Arise and Build. Otherwise, the celebrations continue.
But why don't you show us what you got right here, right now?
Are you serious?
Yes, here now. Help me celebrate Steve the Rev and the media team. We love it, we love it. Thank you so much. And now would you help me turn to your neighbor and tell them, neighbor, in 3 days, we will be gathering here.
We'll be gathering here.
For proclaim.
For proclaim.
Yes, make some noise if you feel what I'm saying. In 3 days, we'll be gathered here to be equipped to be multiplying pastors, ministers, to see multiplication at every level in our churches and in our lives. And our international guests are already flying in. Now for you, if you have not yet paid, I don't know what to do for you. Talk to your shepherd and make your payment today before we close that link. Today, today, today.
Well, do we have any movers and shakers in the building? Now, if you didn't stand up like apostle, that means you're transgressing. You're not a mover and shaker.
Do it again, do it again.
One more time. Do we have any movers and shakers in this building and across this movement? Oh, yeah. Our time is 4 p.m. See you here at Worship Harvest Nadia. And if you're out of the country, suddenly online. Catch us online. We'll be glad to have you join us.
All right. Beautiful. There's a scripture here I want to read for you. It's in 2 Corinthians chapter 9. Verse 6. But this I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap, and he who sows bountifully will also reap. So let each one give. Let what? Your shepherd, your pastor, let each one give as he purposes in his heart, not grudgingly of necessity, for God loves a cheerful giver.
Oh yes, here at Worship Harvest, we do not give towards needs, but we give cheerfully, joyfully, happily, because God has already blessed us and given us everything that pertains to life and godliness. And our positive response to Him is to give back to Him what He has already given us. Now, I know you're going to give very cheerfully, and you can give through these platforms. You can give via mobile money, 0778-618-418, or you can use Airtel 0758-618-418. Our merchant codes are 148-722 for MTN and 116-0032 for Airtel. You can also give via M-Pesa using 406-2191. Remember, if you're sending through any of these platforms and the name you're getting is not Worship Harvest Ministries, you're sending to the wrong number. So get the right number. Otherwise, you can go to www.worshiphavest.org/give for more giving details. Oh, now, yes. As we give, drum rolls.
Hey.
If you guys are not drum rolling, we are not going to do this thing. I said, as we give, drum rolls. Help me welcome our very anointed worship team to lead us. Oh, you can also give through the baskets, in the baskets.
Yes, the world will bow down and say you are God. Every man will bow down and say you are King. So let's Jesus, we just want to be with you. Just want to be with you. Come on, church. Yes, the world.
Us. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of our worship. I can see your neighbor is not clapping. Welcome to Garage this morning. Can we appreciate the worship team? They are a notch above, a cut above, a level above. Hey! Tell your neighbor. So good to see you. You look amazing. Tell them, I know you are amazing as you look. Tell them, neighbor, you're the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. By his stripes you were healed. he became poor that you may become rich. Tell them, neighbor, you are the advantage to your friends, the advantage to your family, the advantage to your nation, the advantage to your generation. Tell them, neighbor, when the world has problems, they look for you because you're a problem solver. Hey, tell them, neighbor, you are the light of the world, a city on a hill. You cannot be hidden. Tell them, neighbor, you are the salt of the earth. Many lives are preserved because of you. Hey! Woo! Tell them, neighbor, you're on the winning team. With long life, God will satisfy you and show you his salvation. Tell them, neighbor, you shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. Tell them, neighbor, when you are old, like Abraham, well advanced in age, the Lord will have blessed you in all things. You'll still be walking straight. You'll have money. You'll have a limousine. You'll go for holidays. Your great-grandchildren are blessed. Hey, sit down. You can even go home now. Some of you needed some prophecy. There's all sorts of things going on. But we are more than conquerors. That song we sang, we win because of you. We overcome and conquer in your name. Hey, amazing. You look awesome. Ah! I'm like, where am I? Is this earth or heaven? I have to keep checking. Welcome. Welcome to Garage. We have children's church. You may be wondering, there are no children in this church. They are there. They are upstairs. If you go through those doors, you'll find fun at a completely different level going on up there. So if you are a child at heart, let nobody stop you. Amen. Our service times have changed here at Worship Harvest Nalia. This is only for Nalia. If you are from another location, please refer to your pastor's instructions. But here at Worship Harvest Nalia, our service times are 8 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 12 o'clock. At 12 o'clock, we have YXP. That's the service of the young, the rich, anointed, and sent, a.k.a. raised. Rich, anointed, young, and sent. That's 12 o'clock. And also, we have Luganda Garage. So Pastor Quaker is in the house. That's the pastor of YXP. And Pastor Ivnu, the pastor of Luganda Garage. Good to see you. Thank you for being here. So that's so you may have come at 9 and wondered, am I too early? Am I too late? What's going on here? Something has changed. Yes, we shifted the service times to give you options to come either earlier or later. But also we're out of parking because of the level of prosperity in this particular church. So we figured we can solve that by having two services so you can have a place to park as opposed to driving around and around and hoping a slot gets free and you can't find it. What a blessing. This is the best time to be alive. Today. Yeah, so if you're planning to take your life, you can stop that immediately because... Sit down. This is a good time to be alive. I just really feel led by the Holy Spirit to say that statement. This is a great time to be alive. Don't be deceived in your mind by whatever is going on. The enemy may whisper some things in your mind to cause confusion. You know, many they say yes, but you come to fight and say, victory is mine, victory is mine. Hey,
There's only one way we're moving. We are moving forward.
So.
That's Jethro on the additional keys. He's not yet married. He's still a student. is he a student of life? Oh, by the way, our first-time guests, you're welcome. I really want to apologize ahead of time for the people at the front and what they are capable of doing. Why do they make noise and move around? Because they are alive. Living things make noise and move around. Okay. That's it. We are very honored this morning to have a wonderful team from New Thing. Oh, yes. You can appreciate them. Where is the camera guy? Oh, they are right here. So New Thing, Sub-Saharan Africa. New Thing is they help Catalyze church planting movements. Back in the day when we had 8 locations and we thought there were too many, we were pulling our hair out and didn't know what to do or how to go to the next level. They came in, they trained us, and in about 18 months, we went from 8 locations to 12 locations. And then we ran into Bishop Dab. So I like to say that New Thing gave us the vision. I remember it was the building, a reproducing church conference in the old auditorium when Matt Miller was speaking, when it finally clicked. Like, okay, this is what must happen. That's when the vision of church planting fully got cemented in my heart. So I like to say New Thing gave us the vision and Bishop Doug gave us the fuel. Yeah, so we have Pastor Benga Sanya in the house with his lovely wife. Oh, yes. And we have Pastor Eric Aluma, who's also the pastor of Life Spring Chapel, Kenya. Also a church planting movement. So you're very welcome. Please have your seats. Awesome. So we are continuing our conversation from last week. Oh, by the way, there were people here at 8 o'clock. They send you greetings. They have since gone home. I don't know to do what, but yeah. Wow. Wow. To create room for your cars. Ma. This is the best church in the whole world. Even if I wasn't the pastor, I would go to this church. Because. Anyway. The Chongeras, you're looking amazing, I think. Where were we? Last week, we started on a series, Flourishing in God's House, and we were sort of casting vision for why we, Worship Harvest Ministries, and your location should be a mega church. Oh, by the way, I didn't make shout-outs to locations, and usually that gets me into trouble. Worship Harvest Bajo, Worship Harvest Germany, USA, United Kingdom, Kigali, Nairobi, Ongatarongai, Juja, Kitengela, Mbale, Budaka, Iganga, Kaliro, Jinja, Wairaka, Magamaga, Bugembe, Budondo, Bulondo, Kamuli, Njeru, Kayunga, Chibibi, Mbarara, Masaka, Liantonde, Nakawa, Bugolobi, Gayaza, Downtown, Kasokoso, Nakwero, Kayunga Wachiso, Kayunga, Muyenga, Garuga, Entebbe Central, Nakawuka, Kasanje, Chitukutwe, Shira, Unsasa, Nabusugwe, Gabarot, Nsambia. Have I mentioned your town? Fort Poto, Kabale,
Kasese, Mpiji, Ibanda, Chichochi Soba, I already said Masaka, Seta, Lugoba, Lusanja, Chebando, Kawempe, Busika, Namlonge, Pererwe, Chanja, Matuga. When I say something and you repeat it, Kula Mbiro Chisasi, Nakulabie, Masanafu, Kamocha, Nachifuma, Natete, Busega, Mbale, Mbale, I finished already. Let's go north. Arua, Gulu, Lira, Nebi, Wandi. Nansana is north. Okay, Nansana. Wachiso, Kachiri, Makerere. The pastor was here earlier. Achibuye, Chibinge, Buziga, Busabala, Nyendo. Kamuli, I already finished. In my head, I have a map. I go one area, then like that. Budo, Chengera, Mitiana, Gomba. So all those are, that's your work. Where are you? I already didn't Kasanje that road, Kasanje da Kawuka. Maybe you missed out to Bunamwaya, Kajansi, and Seguku. And then there's one there, Abaita, Chigungu, Webaja, yes, ETC. Nadia! Nadia, your location pastor is in the house and she's looking amazing. Welcome. Hey, tell your neighbor, the pastor married well. Sit down. 15 reasons why we should be a mega church. We covered 5 last week. I have to do 10 this week. Only God knows how. Reason 1, we should be a mega church because, before going to the wise, Isaiah 2:2, and it shall come to pass in the latter days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established on top of all the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow to it. Mountains are not little small things. Mountains are different from anthills. So, the church, the prophetic destiny of the church is to be like a mountain. The mountain of the Lord's house, and it shall be established where? On top of all the mountains, all the other mountains in the Mount 7 mountain prophecy, they are very important. We need them, family, government, commerce, education, media and entertainment, culture and sports. All those are the mountains of influence in human engagement today. But there's the mountain of faith, the mountain of the Lord's house. Because you see, all those mountains, you can educate a person. You can help a person change their economic status. You can govern the how society runs, etc. But none of those can change the heart of a person. None of those can change a soul into Paul. None of those can change the person that you are, who is seated here. You know who you used to be and how much of the government security money you used to consume by way of how you needed to be watched. And now what happens now? It's the mountain of the Lord's house. So if you find something that works that well, that it changes people from the inside out, you cannot do just a little bit of it. You have to do it at grand scale. And that's the vision of God. And so we looked at a few reasons. Because I know some of you like small churches. You say, I found the small church. Everyone knows everyone. That's not this church. This church is going to change the world. And it's going to change the world whether you participate or not.
So my counsel to you is start participating now by joining a team to serve, starting a missional community, or planting a location. Amen. I'm preaching better than you're listening. Is somebody understanding what I'm talking about? Hey! I'm going to preach myself happy whether you are in it or not. Because this is the sermon that the Lord has given me, and I'm going to speak it out. And I know you are understanding, because none of my words shall fall to the ground. Hey! No weapon formed against you shall prosper, even as a church planter. So this is the mountain of the Lord's house. So reason one, we said we should become a mega church, because the desire for mega church will lead us on a journey that will help us grow. The desire to do big things will lead you on a growth journey. If you have a small vision, you'll only hang out with people with small visions. You'll think like people with small visions. You'll only be educated to the degree of small visions, and then you'll never become a big person. So one of the reasons we should do big things is because the process of doing a big thing converts you. When you find you have to deal with a lot of people, then you have to humble yourself and forgive. Peter asked Jesus, how many times should I forgive per day? Says about 70 times 7. And he didn't specify whether that's for the same sin or... So once you find that you're going to do big things, you immediately convert yourself to being a loving, forgiving, convivial person. The second point, we should become a mega church because most pastors are deceived into thinking that the work is being done when it's not being done. A lot of pastors, they get their nice hall like this one filled up, and then you just feel successful. But the work is not being done. Every Sunday, we have about 15,000 people who gather in Worship Harvest churches. Now, 15,000 is big but tiny. Kampala alone has 7 million people. Greater Kampala, if you add on Wakiso and Tebe, thankfully there is a census coming, and it's going to prove my assertions, I believe. Because I've been talking about the 7 million thing for a long time. And I think some people don't believe me. Now, 7 million people in Greater Kampala alone. These guys come from Lagos. They are 22 million, so they think we are a tiny city. Can you imagine when half of Uganda lives in one city? That's Lagos. So enjoy. So when I tell you buy land, you're like, huh? It is far. Can I tell you something? Far from where? Everywhere is near somewhere. Tell that to your neighbor. Neighbor, buy land anywhere, because everywhere is near somewhere. Everywhere is near somewhere. You're there wasting time drinking bitter drinks instead of buying land. Everywhere is near somewhere. So most pastors are deceived into thinking, and it's a new thing really, which also helped us see this point. Because you can be here and you feel like, hey. You see, if we are not into church planting, this room would be full. And we'll be having several services. And people would be writing about us and saying how we are successful. No, zero. That's why we even started a second service. Because now even the empty chairs had disappeared. Now they are back. Yeah, we now have empty chairs back now that we have two services. So we cannot lie around and be deceived and think the work is... the average size of a church in the world is 70 people. 70. So this group here, from Pastor Ivanu, that, up to the break of the chairs, that's the average size of a church in the world. 70 people. Because those are 8 seats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 rows. That's a church. So if Kampala has 7 million people and you need to plant churches, and the average size is 70. How many churches are those in Kampala alone? Mathematics. Now the school fees has to be justified. I see that my land friends are here, and I'm told they don't like math too much. So, I said this side. So, that's 100,000 churches in Kampala alone. Do you know why Uganda is named among one of the top countries of alcoholism? Because there are no big bars where you have to drive a long distance to go buy a drink. There is a little outlet in every neighborhood. That's why we are drinkers. And if we are to be faithers, there is need for a little outlet in every neighborhood of signs, wonders, miracles, life. That's why you must start a missional community and plant a location and set a hosting center. Oh yes, we are doing this. Look, we are going to do it. Whether you participate or not, our face is set like flint. Anyway, I'm even recapping last Sunday. When are we going to start this Sunday? So most pastors are deceived in thinking the work is done when it is not done. Point three was, we should be a mega church because God's will is that his house may be filled. Yeah, that's in the Bible. So go to the highways and the byways. Why should there be more people outside than inside? Because every empty seat in church represents an empty seat in heaven. So we're going to do evangelism. We're going to do follow-up, visitations, gather the people until every empty seat is filled. And then we'll keep creating more empty seats by starting more services, more locations, and more of that. Point four, we should be a mega church because our harvest field is the world. That was the fourth point. Our harvest field is the world. The world has 8 billion people. It has multiplied eightfold since 1800. In 1800, there was 1 billion people in the world. Today, there are 8 billion people in the world. 7 billion have been added. A multiplication factor of 8 in 200 years. Would you say that the churches have also multiplied by 8? 60% of all the people live in Asia, and Worship Harvest doesn't even have a church there. That's trying to say you're going to do an exam and your strategy is to not answer 60% of the questions and somehow expect to pass. Point five, we should be a mega church because the biblical example of churches in the Bible had thousands. On the day of Pentecost, 3,000 came to the Lord. A couple of weeks later, 5,000. That's what we see in the Bible. Jesus preached to multitudes. Multitudes is not 30. If you find 12 people, don't call them a multitude. Paul found 12 men in Ephesus. He baptized them. He laid hands on them. They were filled with the Holy Spirit. In 2 years, all of Asia had heard the gospel. In 2 years. Oh, yes. Welcome to the Take No Prisoners Ministries. Like, it's either going to get done or it's going to get done. Now, do you want to know the sixth? The worship team doesn't want to know the sixth. Okay. The sixth point. We should be a mega church because in a mega church, more workers and laborers are released to work for God. In a mega church, you have more people serving. 2 weeks ago, I asked about the number of people who had served here, and the number was 250 people. Mechanics who had served in one Sunday. On a typical Sunday, because now we have sort of broken into another service, but before we broke into another service, we used to have 60 children's church facilitators upstairs. 60, because there were 450 kids up there. So
So in a mega church, you have more people serving.
Am I making sense?
If you are serving on a team, if you are serving this morning on a team, you served either in the first service or this service or the services coming, stand up. Let's see you.
Ah. Oh, yes. From the look of things, you can see you are the only one not serving. Anyway, sit down. You have understood. So there are more people to serve.
Yeah. If you are few, then you are few. If you are in a church and you are 13, so how many people are serving? How big is the worship team? Yeah, who is the ushers? All of us. So you see that when a church is big, there are more people to serve, and to serve in different ways, not only in garage, but also in the different spaces where we need people who are helping people. Amen. At Worship Harvest Nalia, we have 194 missional communities. Can I ask all the MC shepherds to stand up? If you are a missional community shepherd, please stand up. You see, all these people are the leaders of God's people. Because of the number of MCs, we are able to reach more people, do evangelism, follow up, visitations. This one doesn't have Wugali, Posho, Kawunga. What? The other one's knees itching. Hey, hospital visits. And all of that work can only be done when there are many people to serve. And our vision for this location, I know we're online and talking to many other people, but for you who are here, is for us to have 1,000 MCs here alone at Worship Harvest Nalia with 10,000 disciples. So, like the people who went to a certain school which I didn't go to, Gachari Mabaga. You can sit. We just began. Amen. Are you understanding? In this church, we believe in church things. Planting churches, MCs, what? Yeah. So if for you, you are only about, I don't know, this, that, the other. Yeah. We'll cover you one day, but right now we are talking about how we can advance the kingdom. Amen. The seventh point, we should become a mega church because in a mega church, more people are involved in prayer against the power of the Prince of the Air. By the way, these points are from Bishop Doug's book, The Mega Church. And he has more, but we only picked a few. Yeah. When more people are involved in prayer, you have more advancement. There's a church in South Korea called the Yodofu Gospel Church, which was founded by Dr. Yonggi Cho. They have a service, a prayer service, every day in the morning at 6 o'clock that has, at least the last time I checked, there will be like 3,000 plus people praying every day, every day. And that church grew to 800,000 members at one point. So we have also decided that here at Worship Harvest Nalia, we are going to have prayer every day at 6 o'clock to 7, except Mondays. Pastor Quaker, stand up. This is Pastor Quaker. If you are interested at all in such things, you talk to him. Tuesday to Sunday, Monday. The Bible encourages us to work 6 days a week. So Monday, if you come, you'll only be praying around the compound there. But the other days, just 1 hour, you're on your way to work, you wanted to beat the traffic and the potholes from a certain direction that I will not name. You're like, if you are here by 7, then the rest can work. You just come, arrive here at 6 o'clock, pray 1 hour, and then go and have a good day. Amen. So, yeah, We have already been doing it, but we had never made it public. So don't think it's just starting. So if you come any day except Monday, there'll be people here praying, and you can join them to pray. Amen. Because in a mega church, there are more people to pray. You know, we have a global prayer center downstairs. And our vision is to have at least two people praying there every hour of every day until Jesus comes back. Have you ever heard of the Moravians? They changed the world. They were one of the most dynamic missionary movements. The Moravians had a prayer meeting, a prayer rotation of people, two people praying every hour non-stop for 100 years at a place called Hainaut. 100 years non-stop prayer. 100 years. Am I talking to worship harvesters? 100 years. The Bible says of Anna, the prophetess, that she served the Lord with prayers and fastings from when she became a widow at a teenage age. And at that time, she was 84 when Jesus was brought into the temple. That's how she served God. Prayers and fastings. So you can be sure she no, that's not going to work. Yeah, prayers and fastings. Tell your neighbor, tell them, look at me. Tell them you're looking at a prayer warrior. So go ahead and book your slot in the Global Prayer Center. It's open 24/7. There's music, there's coffee, there's tea, and there's prayer. There's a carpet, there are seats. Legeda prakasha kataka lamrege zikata. Lekete. Hey! I want you to do it in such a way that you force us to expand it. Amen. Point 8. We should be a mega church because a mega church generates large crowds, and large crowds create great expectation. Now, don't look at me that way. This is true. The spiritual atmosphere of a small group is different from the spiritual atmosphere of a large crowd. Luke 3:15. Now, as the people were in expectation and all reasoned in their hearts about John, whether he was the Christ or not. The people were in what? Expectation. Imagine you went to a church and you found there are seven people. How great would your expectation be? You are like, man, miracles are going to happen here today. Wow, there is a whole seven people. It doesn't work. You ask the preachers here, they will tell you. Yeah, if you find a scant crowd, you find that even your anointing is drastically reduced. It diminishes. The law of diminishing anointing. The smaller the crowd. That's why at crusades where you see lots of miracles, I've attended Bishop Doug's crusades, you'll just be like, what on earth is going on? The miracles are mind-blowing. And you just pray a short prayer. Just, put your hand wherever it is. Before you know it, wheelchairs are being lifted all over the place. People are coming up, blind eyes, in minutes. But there's like 100,000 people there. It's huge. Now you say you're going to do a crusade in your village. And you advertise miracles. Yeah. Huh? Evangelists. Can't you see me? My friend. Hey, be careful with those things. I hear bring the sick, the lame, the dead. Then you get to the Kasawe. You know Kasawe? Like a field you've hired. There are 35 people outdoors. You'll just feel like
The power is too low. Jesus preached to multitudes. Yeah. So there are things that, I'm not saying that that's the rule. I mean, there are people who receive their miracles one-on-one. Jesus healed people one-on-one. But you find that there is great expectation of good things in a mega church than in a small church. One of these days, you're going to go and plant a church. I'm just advising you that you will find out that it's different when there are more people than when there are fewer people. You're already finding out. Mercy, Lord. Are you enjoying this message? Point what? 9. We should become a mega church because more evangelism is possible through a mega church. More evangelism. Let me read for you something here. You see, because of our size, most weeks when we announce the numbers, Worship Harvest Nalia is on top with salvations. Why? Because we have more missional communities reaching out to do more evangelism. So this past week, we had 570 salvations all across the church. But Nalia was the first one with 89 salvations. Gayaza, 63. Nakawa, 31. Nairobi, 28. Mbarara, 26. Matuga, 22. Bugembe, 20. Downtown, 16. Jogo, 14. Bugolobi, 13. Bweyogerere, 12. Makerere, 12. And others. Now, you see, when you have more people doing outreach, you will have more salvations. If you have only one person doing outreach, if you have only 10 people doing outreach, you're not going to get many people born again. Yeah, our vision is to do evangelism through the missional communities, mostly. We also do it using other methods, but it's mostly through the MCs. And the idea is for every missional community to lead one person to Christ a week. So we here at Nalia with 194, we should be doing about at least 194 salvations a week. It's just that some of you went out and you caught nothing the whole night, like the disciples. Others, your boats are on the shore, you have not gone out to fish. Yeah, you're just frying Rolex by the lakeside and the boat is there, it is catching algae. You have not gone into the fields. What a shock. Tell the neighbor, I'm changing it. Do you know that in Winners Chapel, the expectation is for every person to witness to at least one person a day, every day. Every day. So first, we are still doing a group a week. We may need to switch it up if... Let me continue. I'm preaching good. When I talk about witnessing, why do people go quiet? I'm witnessing. I thought he says, you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, Judea. So. Okay, we are together. So, more evangelism. Amen. Can I tell you one quick step to kill a church? One. You don't even need many steps. Just one. Stop evangelism. Once you stop evangelism, the church dies naturally. And it's not because there are no new people coming in, no. Because evangelism is the driver of all the other essential church practices. Evangelism is the driver of prayer. Do you know why you didn't pray or you don't like praying? Because you're not doing outreach. Once you do outreach without praying, you'll find one of those seven sons of Sceva situations where they'll say, Jesus, we know. Paul, we know. Who are you? And then you realize, I should never go out without praying. Oh, yes. And then once you start doing evangelism and new people are coming into the church, then you realize you have to teach properly, not these teachings of you know, abomination of the desolation. Because you realize people don't know the basics. You are there preaching, someone lights a cigarette. And you're like, huh? Brother, what's up? He says, hey, you mean this is not allowed? Then you know now you have to teach that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit and other things. Yeah, once you do evangelism, you have to pray and you have to teach. And those are the essential things. And you have to establish the members. You have to visit. Amen. Yeah. Okay. There's a way in which I'm of enjoying this message. I don't know. Number 10 is a bit like one of the previous ones. We should be a mega church because in a mega church you'll have a greater manifestation of miracles because of the greater crowds and greater expectation. Yeah. If you have a miracle service and 17 people come, and you know all of them. Look. It will be a difficult miracle service because it will be like, you'll even say, who needs a miracle? And everyone is like, I actually don't need a miracle. But we have a miracle service. So why are we having a miracle service for people who don't need a miracle? But realize that when there are lots of people, the chances that there are people who need a touch from God about different issues are higher. Are you understanding? Now, whether some of you are looking at me, you're like, what is he talking about? So next time you hear there's a miracle service, make sure you come with many friends who need a touch from God. Because you may not need it. You have already read the Bible, believed God for several things. You are way advanced. Everything, you operate by faith. There are people who are not where you are. But now if you're 17 and everyone can quote the book of Leviticus, it's going to be like, what are we doing here? It's complicated. Point 11. We should be a mega church because a mega church, point 11 is important. Say it's important. Tell your neighbor, he's about to say something important. A mega church has a larger and greater income that can be used for the work of God. That one we've learned by experience. And all the other pastors who are logged into this message, they are also learning by experience that when you have a small church, you can have a passionate vision. You really want to change the world. Yeah. Then the offering comes in. And realize you owe the landlord, you owe the guy of the loudspeakers, you owe the guy who transported the loudspeakers, you owe the guy of the chairs. Yeah. And after some time, you realize we need to close. It's not working. You know, when we started Worship Harvest, we met at a restaurant, and the restaurant owners sent us to the veranda of the restaurant because they thought we were too few to fill the restaurant. We used to pay 30,000 Uganda shillings a Sunday. 30,000 Uganda shillings at that time was about $15. Prosy was there. We never paid two Sundays in a row. Yeah. And I'm not sure I'm at liberty to tell you why we never paid two Sundays in a row. Yeah. Just know by the time they expelled us, we were not in arrears. Huh? What are you talking about? We were also about 20-something in number. Yeah, that was a whole church. So you take this row, and you add this row, and then you add half of that row, and the whole movement of Worship Harvest International Ministries. Yeah. The mega church. We are going to change the world. But the landlord wants his 30K. Why are you disturbing? We are so young, we didn't have children. Yes. So, today, cathedrals, churches, schools, what God has been kind. But that's all that is possible because of all of you. When you have more people putting their hand to the plow, tithing faithfully. Yeah, if you're not tithing, you're not helping the cause. Yeah, God has set up the system God has set up for financing the church and the gospel is tithe. Yeah, don't get into arguments. That's it. It's tithe. So you give your tithe. The tithe doesn't go to the pastor. Me, I don't take any of your tithe. It goes to the church. And then the church uses that money to do all these things. Didn't you enjoy the parking on a thing there where you're no longer... Well, you have to come with two sets of shoes. The ones for between the parking lot and the church, and then the ones for entering. Or you tie Cavera on the shoes. Now the place is paved, tarmac, tiles, lights, screens. Those days you used to squint to see whether the image is what. But now you can see everything. All that is tithe. Don't think we have some sponsor from America. No, we don't. Yeah, people come here. Which Mzungu is sponsoring this church? Zero. Okay? Yeah, it is your tithe. So you are the Mzungu. Shout, I'm understanding. Tell your neighbor, I'm a tither. I hope you're not saying that by faith. Yeah. Who is that one who doesn't like my message? In a mega church, there is more resources. And we are putting our hand to the plow. We are determined. We are building. Building is expensive. Yeah. So now we have 9 cathedrals. Yeah, 9. Ginger is just a few days away from use because we've done most of the work. Just windows and toilets and we are good to go. And some paint if you need it. Who said you need paint? We use this place without paint, without tiles, without whatever for a long time. And people came to Christ. Yeah. We just got our approvals for another city in the country, far from here. We are starting construction in about 2 weeks of our 10th cathedral. We are starting our 10th cathedral this month. I'm believing God will do 4 this year. So Jinja is 1. This next one is Arua, actually. And then we have 2 more. Nearby, around Kampala. And then, plus now these other smaller ones we are building in Kasanje and Busika, and I don't know, so many places. Yeah, Busika is actually now under use. They're using it already. That's because there are many people giving the resources. It's not those things of you sit down with a few individuals and tell them all of you have to sell your houses or that one. No. It's everyone giving as the Lord has
enabled you, as the Lord has blessed you. And we are committed to being good stewards of what you give and show results. Oh, yeah. Yeah, leaders who don't show results shouldn't lead. Okay. That was point what? 12. Do you want point 12? We should be a mega church because special ministries which take care of special needs will develop within a mega church. So when you're a big church, you can start taking care of special issues, special ministries. And we have quite a few of those that have started, mostly through our frontiers. And I want to again clap for the mission of community shepherds. I know that you do a lot. But now also we are starting to help out some of the children, especially those who lead, like they lead missional communities. They are not able to go to school on time because mother is still looking for school fees. You don't want mother to get into debt. And this time alone, we are helping 120 kids. So those special ministries are possible because of you. Yeah. And others. Other things we just... We don't want to talk too much because other people, they talk too much. They want, you do something small, it has to be in the papers. No. We just want to help. We are a family, so we just want to help each other move forward. Make sure you don't leave anyone behind. But all that is possible because it's a mega church. Yeah. There are some people who are stuck in school. And we came up with something called the College Fund to help them get through uni, so you graduate, so you can go get a job. So there are all these things. There are so many special ministries here. Think about BLN, Business Leaders Network. If you're not part of that, you're missing out on the best deals. Business Garage, all that is special ministries. Luganda Garage, special ministries. There are so many different things. Schools, we do medical outreaches. Do you know we do medical outreaches? But we don't make noise. We don't make films about it and then go begging for money. No. We just tell our doctors, get this cathedral, go on this Saturday, and they go and they can treat hundreds of people. They do a good job. They come back. They're happy to do it because we have many doctors in the church. So we don't have to, everything is not for looking for money. And everything is not for advertising. We just do it because it's the right thing to do. We should be a mega church because in a mega church there are more beloved or potential marriage partners. Whoa. If I know people, stand up if you got your spouse in this church. But first sit down. You'll see so many people standing up. But, you know, you're a sister, marriageable age, beautiful. What? You're waiting on the Lord for a brother. Then you end up in a church of 13 people. And there's no brother there who... That's why you should come to this church, because here we have variety, all the different types. We have the tall ones, we have the short ones, we have the thin ones, we have the blessed ones, we have the young ones, we have the older ones. Oh yeah, oh yes, this is the best place to get a spouse. Don't go single. You know, you're not Paul. You're not Saint Paul. We know your name. Why are you touching your neighbors? I personally think that the best, most anointed, most beautiful, most well-taught girls are in worship harvest. So, brothers, don't be confused.
Just come and serve on a team. And don't miss the gatherings. Because in the gatherings, you get to meet even those from other locations. So the sample space even increases. Now, some of you may be there saying, it's church, they are not even serious. How can you even be talking about that on the pulpit? Okay. Okay, you only want us to talk about heaven and going. Nainga, you're brokenhearted. Here we talk about everything to do with life and godliness. So I know there are people who need someone to propose to them. And the proposer is just confusing. And yet we are even about to install a propose to me chair in the Brain Cafe. So when the brother takes you for chips and chicken at the Brain Cafe and they keep taking, one time you say, I'm sitting on this one. I'm sitting on this chair. And once the sister sits on that chair and there are other witnesses around, they will wonder why you're not. They will wonder why you are not showing cause. The sister has sat on the propose to me chair. You're there looking as if your specs don't work. Those who don't like our propose to me chair. Hey. And I seriously, in a larger church, there are more beloved people to propose to get married to. You join fireplace, you find help. Yeah, as opposed to being isolated and thinking, hey, did I make a mistake? No, go for fireplace. You find all the things you're quarreling about are not complicated at all. Oh, yeah. What's the beauty of a mega church? So sisters, just relax. The brothers are seeing. Man talk is solving us. Point 14, we should be a mega church because there are more contacts and connections. Three people in the mega church. There are more contacts and connections. I am always on like BLN and other groups where people say, hey, I need someone who can do this. Oh, furniture maker, whatever. Who knows someone, this. And in minutes, there is always a contact given. Call this person. Try this person. etc. That's how community works. So if we decided to be a tiny church, then you couldn't find all those. By show of hands, how many of you have ever found a contact, maybe business contact or service contact, something that you needed to be done, and you got the contact because of church? By show of hands. So those whose hands I don't know where you've been looking. I think you're on the wrong groups. 15, we should be a mega church because in a mega church, there's always a large pool of employers who can help employ church members as long as they don't misbehave at work because the employer is a brother or sister in Christ. Those last parts I added. The other day we sat down with Pastor Julius and we were thinking, how do we create 1,000 jobs in the worship harvest ecosystem through our affiliate organizations? Yeah, and we are working on it. We already have created about 140 jobs. But our target is 1,000 jobs in about 2 years. So that in about 2 years, 1,000 people should be employed in worship harvest related entities. Yeah, and that's internal. Then there's external. Those like BLN, where through training, businesses are growing and they're employing more people. Because also in BLN, we have a vision of raising 1,000 businesses with a valuation of at least 1 billion shillings.
Yeah, so that BLN alone has a trillion. It's not complicated. You can do it. Now imagine 1,000 companies with a valuation of at least a billion. How many people are they each employing? It's difficult to have a company of a billion when you don't employ anyone, where you are down with a key to the toilet and whatever. You see, so that's how you change the economy of the country. You don't change the economy by complaining. Are you understanding? The mountain of the Lord's house. Many beloveds, many couples, many contacts, many places of help. Many of you here, when you've lost your loved ones, who showed up? Yeah, church. If you lose your loved one and your church has 7 people, already you are the 7th. Now the other 6, each one has to hold one part of the coffin. Who will dig? I'm just saying things that no one says. But they have to be. And one is pregnant, they can't come. Well, you're reduced to 5. But if they are pregnant and they are married to a church member, that makes 2 of them. But by the grace of God, we are becoming a mega church so that we can help each other better. We can help the community around us better. You see, when we become better, everyone else becomes better. When we change the environment, it helps everyone. When we open schools, they help everyone who wants to bring their kids. We have a school here, all the parents are not worship of his parents. Okay, so that's why we should not be contented to be a small group of people who are growing all together to go to heaven together and even have our graves in the churchyard. No. We must go out. We must plant 3,000 churches. In the next, it used to be 20 years, now it's 18 years. Amen. Let's stand and close this service. Oh, yes, tell your neighbor, neighbor. Welcome to the mega church. Now, in all of this, the owner of the church is Jesus Christ. For us, we are just servants. In fact, the Bible calls us unprofitable servants. The owner of all of this, the boss, the master, his name is Jesus. And he has sent us because he loves people. He loves you. Who's here today? He loves you who's listening to me online. You're the apple of his eye. You are the God is doing everything possible to love people. And God loves you. And I don't know, today our message was very missional, very about the vision of the church because we are celebrating 18 years. But you may have come and your need is very personal. And you're wondering if God cares about you. God cares about you. He knows your pain. He knows the confusion. He knows the challenge. And he is solving it, whether you know it or not. His word is sharper than any two-edged sword and will bring about change and life. Amen. So I just want you to take a moment and just pray and commit your week to God. Commit whatever thing may be bothering you, whatever you may have walked in with, just commit it to God. Just tell him, Lord, I surrender this thing. I surrender this conflict. Maybe you are in conflict. Someone, you are in conflict with a close person. Maybe your spouse. Maybe your family. Maybe your workmates. Surrender it. Surrender that conflict. Whatever it is, maybe it's conflict, maybe it is sickness, just let go. God will take care of it. God will heal you. He says in Jeremiah 30:17, for I will restore health to you and heal you of your wounds.
Because they called you an outcast, saying, "This is Zion, no one cares for her." But you shall be healed. You shall find grace to help in time of need. Right now, keep praying. Pray in the Spirit, those who know how to do that. Just pray in the Spirit. Just everyone praying. The rest of you, just surrender it. Surrender it. Whatever it is. I feel this morning like there's a need for people to lay down burdens. Burdens you've carried for weeks, for months, for days. Something weighing you down. And right now, in the name of Jesus, Holy Spirit, take over right now. Lift every burden. Take it away. Whatever the children of God have carried, things to do with health, things to do with relationships, things to do with finances. Maybe you find yourself in a difficult financial situation and it's a burden that's weighing you down. Maybe you've lost a loved one and the pain is still too much. You don't know how you'll go past this season. I can tell you, God is with you. He's watching out for you and He wants to love you this morning. So Father, we thank You. We surrender these things to You and we say, have Your way. Have Your way. There are people, even as we continue praying, there are people you've had like oppressive dreams. Oppression, when you're sleeping, you wake up breaking out in a sweat. You have dreams where animals are chasing you, or people, or things like that, where you're not having great nights. I want to pray for you. If you're there and you're that person, just put your hand up so that I pray for you wherever you are. You don't have to come to the front. Thank You, Father, for those whose hands are up. I command an end to this assault from the enemy. Your word declares that in the latter days I'll pour out My Spirit and your children, your sons and daughters shall dream dreams, not dreams of fear, but dreams of progress, dreams of courage, dreams of advancement. We put an end to every dream of fear, every oppression of the enemy. Oh yes, you shall have sweet sleep. No more shall you be oppressed in your sleep. Thank You, Lord. I bless You because You're faithful to do it. In Jesus' name, amen. In Jesus' name. Oh yes, shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Amen. Thank You, Lord. If you're sick in any part of your body, I just want to pray for you. God will heal you. I don't heal, God heals. Ours is to join our faith. So I want you to put your hand up and let's pray. Thank You, Father, for the hands lifted. Thank You. We cancel any report that puts a timeline to a person's life here. Any report where you've been told that you have such and such amount of time to live, we cancel it right now. Right now. Even for your loved ones. In the name of Jesus. The only one with authority over life is God. Not man. Not Satan. And so none of the days allotted to you shall be stolen. But you shall live out your full life. With long life He satisfies you. Thank You, Father, for the hands that are lifted. I pray that the healing power of Jesus will start to operate right now. In every part of their body and mind and soul. I bless you and I thank you because I know they will come back with a testimony saying it is well, it is well, it is well with you. In Jesus' name. Amen. We are closing. If you've never given your life to Jesus, you've never made a public confession to say, Lord, save me. If you cannot confidently say, I'm born again. I know my destiny. I know my future. I've given my life to the Lord. I want us to pray. I want to pray with you. I don't want you to go home without taking salvation for yourself. Amen. Salvation is free. Completely free. But Jesus said that whoever denies me before men, I'll deny them before my Father. So I want to give you an opportunity. Maybe you're online. Maybe you're in the room. Maybe you're in one of our locations or hosting centers, wherever you are, you're saying, Pastor, pray for me. I want to receive Jesus. Please put your hand up. Just put it up. Just put it up. Just put it up. Just put it up. You're saying, I want, thank you for that hand. Anyone else? Anyone else? Anybody else? Whether you're upstairs or downstairs, we want to pray with you. I see that hand. Anyone else? Anyone else? Anyone else? Anyone else? This is your moment. This is your day of salvation. Come here. Come, come. Let's pray together. Oh, yes. Can we celebrate as they come? May God bless you. I'm going to kubonga you like this. Oh, yes. Welcome, my sister. Welcome to the kingdom of God. Anybody else? They're coming. Let's celebrate as they come. Church, welcome, my sister. God bless you. Your life will never be the same. Children, oh, your lives will never be the same. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Today is the day of salvation. Come, 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 come. There are people coming from that side. Talk to your neighbor. Ask them, have you made a commitment or do you want me to walk with you? In this church, during the altar call, we all support Liverpool because they say you will never walk alone. You will never walk alone in Christ. You will never walk alone to give your life to Jesus. Welcome, my sister. This is the best decision of your life. God bless you. Welcome, my brother. Oh, yes. Powerful people are coming to the front to give their lives to Jesus. Anyone else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Anybody else? Today is the day of salvation. It's free. It's available. And your life will never be the same. Your life will never be the same. Oh, can I give you a fist bump? God bless you. Oh, yes. Somebody here. God bless you, sir. You're amazing. You're amazing. More people coming. Let's receive them with a celebration, with joy. Oh, yes. God bless you, my sister. Your lives will never be the same. Ever, 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 ever. Woo! God bless you, my sister. Yay! Yay! Your celebration is lousy. God is saving souls. I expect you to be excited about it. God bless you. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. More people coming to the Lord this morning. God bless you, my sister. Oh, yes. Anybody else? Anybody else? Today is a day of salvation. Yay. Anybody else? Ooh, isn't God amazing? I want you to give a mighty shout of praise to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Can I pray with you? Just put your hand in your chest and pray this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, thank you for today. Thank you for saving me. I come to you. I ask for forgiveness. Give me new life. Fill me with your Holy Spirit that I may walk with you and serve you the rest of my life. Today, I receive you as my Lord and Savior. And I thank you for saving my life. Amen. Amen. Awesome. Now, this is Pastor Stephen. He's going to go with you over there, just here where these windows are. Just write your name so that we can reach out to you and pray for you by name. We love to pray for you by name. Can you just go with him? Can we celebrate as they go? Oh, yes. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Hallelujah. YXP is going to start 10 minutes late. 10 minutes late. Actually, 15. At 12:15, YXP will start. In YXP, we know how to, you know, make it, wing it. So, and I want to thank you. God bless you. Can I pray for you? May God bless you. May He cause His face to shine on you and give you peace. And may the peace of God that surpasses all understanding
Guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. May you lack nothing good. May we hear good news from your household. We cancel every plan of the enemy concerning accidents, bodily harm, and other such things. None of that shall come near you. And for those who may be in any kind of sickness, we speak speedy healing and recovery, miraculous recovery and healing. May God provide for all your needs and beyond that. And may you have a wonderful, wonderful week ahead. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forever. Amen. Our first time guests, please follow this lovely lady, and we would like to have a moment with you. God bless you. Thank you so much for coming.